Hello. I would like to mention something about my experience with Rambha Durbhumjan during the time when he was keeping me on chains tied to a tree in the jungle in 2012 after he had kidnapped me. He had ordered his followers to kidnap me, and after he tortured me, let me sexually attacked by his follower Darshan, and just before releasing me, there were a few very interesting things which the Nepali police, Interpol also, because foreigners are also in this case criminals, and Interpol should also watch out, because there are many Europeans and Americans and Canadians, Australians and Japanese people who are involved in the criminal attacks against me and against most of the 72 victims of Bhumjan, many of whom had disappeared. More than 10 people disappeared, and there had been murders, well-known murders. They are not even secret, like the murder of an American psychiatrist, Dr. Moore, and the murder of Manomaya Tamang Bhumjan's own sister, and eyewitnessed murder of Sanchalal Vaiba, old monk of Bhumjan, actually by lynching at his own order. There had been two eyewitnesses. So, concerning my case, it is all over in the media, in my videos, so I'm not going into the details and the preparation of my kidnapping now, but I didn't mention this element before, because to tell the truth, I was also scared. I am still somehow scared, because neither the Nepali police, neither the Nepali CID or any international Interpol or any police, not speaking about United Nations, which are supporting Bhumjan, because they are allowing the flag of United Nations to be waved on his events, during which events there are people killed, tortured, chains draped. Okay, so there is an interesting element. Before I had been released, I had been not released, of course, we are in Nepal, I had been not released by the police, as the police is lying in the media until now that Slovak woman had been rescued, Slovak woman had been released by the police. No. Police was cooperating with Bhumjan. They had been coming, going to the Halkoria jungle, where me and poor old Mata Ani, she was also accused by Bhumjan of being a witch like me, we were two chained and tortured in that jungle, 3 months. As far as I know, she was only 2 months, she came later, but I have never seen her. I did hear the chains. So imagine you are chained in the jungle, more or less alone, but you hear, because it's very near to the settlement of your previous former co-devotees. So it's not that I would not hear that there is some life. Yes, I did hear, but there was a fence, a barbed wire fence, not one, 3 levels of barbed wire fences, protecting any untoward visitor who would venture to the place where I was tied. I was tied to a tree near Bhumjan's own villa, which had been not bulldozed down until today. They tried it, they didn't have the technical background in 2012 to bulldoze it down. So just for the orientation, you can still find it on Google Earth satellite photos. The area where I had been chained to the tree was practically very near to the area where hundreds of Nepalis, most of them Tamangs, and foreigners had been living a happy life, hugging each other, as I saw in the later photos, hugging each other with love, speaking about maitri, compassion, and spreading this beautiful dharma to the whole world. But in that same, very same time, in the full knowledge of the majority of these people, I had been tortured, chained, and raped regularly in that same area. And Mata Ani is obvious that she as well. Though during the time I was there, I only heard her complaining, crying, like in Nepali she was crying, Amma, Amma, which means mommy, mommy, because she must have been in an extreme, like me, of course, in an extreme despair, fear, terror, torture. Yes, everyone is afraid to be alone in the jungle as well. And they were coming to beat her, torture her, break their bones, similarly like me, regularly. So I was... it was terrible, of course. You are tortured yourself and then you know that there is someone else. I learned that it's her only later when I was rescued, and I learned it from the media, and of course I learned it from the people when I was when I came out and told, and where is Mata Ani, and did they rescue Mata Ani, and did you see Mata Ani, and I didn't even know there is some person called Mata Ani. I just heard there was a woman inside, but you know, I was a ruin. You can see I was so much full of terror, and I survived my death. I survived hell. So I really, they didn't give me any condition, any medical treatment, so that I could, in a normal situation, or protection, any victim protection, any witness protection doesn't exist in Nepal.